Hi everyone, I'm Mom and welcome to Momda's Life Handmade. And today I'm going to share with you 5 magical DIYs. These are magical, they make beautiful fall decor because of the fall colors in them, yet very neutral as well as modern at the same time. And I'm going to use these 5 magical DIYs that I make today to create a little vignette or a centerpiece or a corner decor that you can use in your home for this fall as well as Halloween. Since it's magical, it's Harry Potter themed, this can be stretched up to Halloween as well. My today's video is part of the challenge that is being hosted by Julia from the Mug Life DIY and is being co-hosted by Kiki from Kiki DIYs. So I'll put link to both Kiki and Julia's channel in the description box of this video and also give link to the playlist where you can find more ideas related to Harry Potter decor. And if you're new to this channel, a warm welcome. A look around in the content. If you like it, if you like DIYs, if you love trash to treasure, high-end tubes, everything related to home within budget, please subscribe to my channel by hitting the red subscribe button given below the video and do hit that little bell icon next to it and choose the ringing bell icon so that you're notified each time I post a video. For the first DIY, I'm making a Harry Potter themed banner. I just love banners, they look good everywhere, even small as well as big. So basically I'm taking some cardstock paper, this is dark, deep aubergine colored paper, and I'm just going to cut out small rectangles out of it. I have cut already a few and I'm going to do the last one. So basically take a slant up. So using this as the first one as a guide, I'm just taking a slant up till the midpoint and then again from the other end slant up till the midpoint to get this swallowtail shape. So I have 5 such here. So now you can do black on white. I'm doing white on a dark background because this will look better on my lighter background. Next, I'm just taking a fine tip brush and some acrylic paint and making some symbols, some designs which are relevant to Harry Potter. There's the famous car and Harry Potter glass. Pieces are ready. I'm taking a jute string and instead of just stringing everything below, which is one option, I'm just going to glue them at the back or just use a tape at the back. So that makes things much more easier and faster to do. So similarly, I'm going to add all of them here at a little distance. And here is my tiny little Harry Potter themed banner ready. Let's get on to the next DIY. This next DIY is even more easy. I've taken a card paper, already cut out card paper, or you can take a cardstock paper and just measure and cut it out in your desired size. A picture of your choice. I've just taken a random picture. You can put picture of your family member or friends or your own self. And a black pen. And I've drawn faint lines here using ruler so that I'm evenly spaced. You can even typewrite this whole message and just write these words. Now, witch or wizard depends on whose picture you are placing here. And you can write the name of the person or some message down below. Final step, just
paste this picture right in the center. And because it's a card, it can stand on its own and it's ready to go. Have you seen this witch? For my next DIY, I'm using this butter paper. It's translucent, and that's the reason why I'm using this. I'm using an old key, and let's make the key that was there in the philosopher's stone. So I'm going to make wings with this. So for that, to get the symmetrical wings, I'm folding the paper into half and then make the outlines of the wings and then just cut it out. And I'm using some gold pen to make some designs over this. Now, as this is butter paper, I'll wait for this to slightly dry and then glue it over my key. Now, in the meanwhile, I need to make this key look a little more old. I'm using a little acrylic paint in my brush and just brushing over it lightly. Just to let the shine just goes away and it looks old. I'm also using little red here and there for the rusted look. Let this also dry. I realized a black or a dark background would be better so that you can see. So the wings are dry and the key looks rusted and old. And I'm just going to take a dab of glue and glue it just below this ring, and this will look perfectly like the Harry Potter's key. Let's make a very quick sign using cardstock paper that can be propped against any surface, any wall, or on any picture stand or plate stand. So I've taken this cardstock paper, it has this faint lines over it. I'm going to enhance it further. Some crayons. Wingardium Leviosa. This DIY is, I think, the most easiest and the most popular DIY on net. So I've taken two pencils here. These are in dark colors. You can take colors of your choice, maybe yellow or straw colored. And I'm using, people use different things. I'm using this hay or straw, some rubber bands or elastic bands. This is an option if you want to make it a temporary piece. But for making a permanent decor piece, one can use some strong glue or glue gun for this purpose instead of rubber bands. And of course, some scissors. So I'm going to cut this straw and make the broom here. So almost 1.5 inches long. So I'm going to collect all these. So here is a bunch, and at the back side, this is the side which will get sharpened. So on the back side, I'm going to, it should be enough that it covers the pencil from all sides. Just hold it tight, either glue it right away or use a rubber band for this. And here I have the first broom. Similarly, I'll make the second one. So here are two broomsticks. Anybody who loves Harry Potter, loves to read and write, would love these pencils. Let's decorate. So I'm going to create a vignette with today's DIY. So here we have the mini banner, the pencil brooms, the swish and flick sign, and the picture. And I'm also, yes, here is the key. So for this vignette, I have taken a tray. So if you notice, I have taken a color combination of black and golden yellow against the white. So this is with some natural touch. So this is the basic color scheme that I'm going for the fall flavor. So I have a tray here. This is another DIY tray out of cardboard, a trash to treasure. It's in my fall DIY as well as DIY and decor playlist. Very popular video. And this is a very sturdy one. I'm using this. It has a small handle with some jute. This portion I have kept in front. Here I have stack of books which are in black color. So I picked up books from my home which are mainly in black color, stacked them together. Now one can use the other side and have the old book feel, or use some old books as well. I wanted the black color scheme to be here, so I'm using this. So I also have in the same color scheme a mug which is black outside, golden yellow inside. I've taken another mug here in pale white creamy ceramic mug, and this is tie of my husband, but it had quite similar, not exactly, but similar colors to Gryffindor, so I have that. So now let's just start decorating. So here is my magical vignette for this fall, for the magical Halloween time in Harry Potter style. I love the colors, black, white, yellows, sunny yellows, and all the magical elements from Harry Potter theme. The broom, even the quills in form of feathers have come here. Have you seen the switch? Swish and flick, the magical key for opening the magic door, for the philosopher's stone, a sunflower to add some color, little green, cute little banner with all the symbols here. I think this has turned out cute, beautiful, and a lovely decor, especially because of the color scheme. What do you think? Do let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share this video, write down your comments. If you're new here, I would really appreciate if you subscribe to my channel and support it. I thank you all for your time, and I'll see you soon in my next video, in my next DIY. Until then, stay positive, be creative, and be happy.